It is our duty to read their sacrifices so that we will love them and we will be able to appreciate what happened. Do you know how they dealt with difference of opinion? If we had to look into it, we would know how to deal with difference of opinion amongst us as well. Subhanallah. They always try to find out, what did Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? What did he do? Let us ask him. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the final stopping point. And this is why Allah says,
فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِيمَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِّمَّا قَضَيْتَ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا.
Nay, they are not true believers until they surrender to your decision in their dispute, to your ruling regarding their disputes. Nobody is a true believer until and unless he considers the solution or the ruling of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the dispute as the final ruling. And this was revealed at the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for the disputes that may have taken place at the time. And Allah says, after that, true believers must not even feel in their hearts for a moment that, you know what, I've lost something. They must be happy with that decision and they must surrender completely. May Allah grant us ease. One day, سَمِعَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ جَلَبَةَ خَصْمٍ بِبَابِ حُجْرَتِهِ فَخَرَجْ. He heard صلى الله عليه وسلم some people arguing by his door, so he came out. And when he came out, he saw two people disputing over something. So he spoke to them and he told them that, look, you guys are disputing over this particular ownership of the item. And I want to tell you that I will give a ruling based on whoever presents their evidence better. Listen to this. I will give a ruling based on the evidence and whoever presents it better. Sometimes people are more eloquent. You know, you have a person who is guilty, who sometimes has a mouth that takes him out of the guilt. Like they say, this guy can talk his way out of anything, you know? And whereas you have an innocent person sometimes who really is so soft and quiet that even when people oppress him or her, they're quiet about it. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, I will give a ruling based on the evidence, but I want to tell you, if it belongs to you, alhamdulillah. If it does not belong to you, remember one thing, it is a piece of the fire. فَلْيَأْخُذْهَا أَوْ لِيَذَرْهَا فَإِنَّمَا هِيَ قِطْعَةٌ مِّنَ النَّارِ فَلْيَأْخُذْهَا أَوْ لِيَذَرْهَا. Indeed, it is a piece of hellfire. If it is not yours, you choose to take it or to leave it. Guess what happened? Both of them left the item and went away. Because they were worried, concerned. Now with us, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a lesson. And may He make us from those who take heed. Brothers and sisters, we have a history that has been beautified with great sacrifice. Great sacrifice. And believe me, the deen has come to us through the sacrifice of those radiyallahu anhum. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with them. And this is why Allah says,
لَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ يُبَايِعُونَكَ تَحْتَ الشَّجَرَةِ فَعَلِمَ مَا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ فَأَنزَلَ السَّكِينَةَ عَلَيْهِمْ وَأَثَابَهُمْ فَتْحًا قَرِيبًا.
Allah has become pleased with those who pledged allegiance with you under the tree, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on the occasion of Hudaybiyah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, not only has He become pleased with them, but He will grant them that peace that they are searching for. He sent down to them the peace that they were searching for, and He has informed them of a near victory. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us victory. But if we would like that victory, we need to develop the link with Allah. Learn to surrender to the law of Allah. Learn to surrender to the statements of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Remember, there will always be people who try to look for an excuse to turn away from the deen, or an excuse in order to justify their wrongdoings. We should not be from amongst those. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us.